All right, getting started with the Raspberry Pi Pico. So let's scroll down and see what we're going to be doing. So it looks like we're making a classic blinking LED. Let's see what's required. So a Raspberry Pi Pico with soldered headers. So I guess we'd better get some headers onto our Raspberry Pi Pico. So the easiest way to do this is to actually put the headers into a breadboard and then rest the Raspberry Pi Pico on top of these headers, and that gives you a nice stable platform to solder the device on, and you'll get nice square headers that fit nicely into a breadboard. So we'll get all these headers lined up. It can be quite hard to push the headers into the breadboard, but wiggle them around and they'll go in nicely. So with the headers in place, we can just put the Pico on top and it's nice and firmly held, and now we just solder up each pin in turn. Some of the pins do have quite a large ground plane attached, so they may take a bit more time on the soldering iron to solder, but most of them should solder up pretty straightforwardly. So that's our board all nicely soldered up. We'll do a quick visual inspection to make sure everything is properly soldered and it all looks pretty good. So let's see what's next in the list of instructions. So next in our requirements is a computer, which I think we have, and some electronics components. So an LED, a resistor, potentiometer, breadboard. Well, we've just soldered our Pico into a breadboard, and I think I've got a power pack around, so I've got a 5-volt USB power source. So let's see what's next. So we're going to install the MicroPython framework, and we're going to learn all about that. We're going to learn to program the Pico, how to connect it. Okay, next. So, well, here's our Pico. I think we've seen that just now. So put it in the breadboard. I've done that, so that's good. And plug it in, and we've done that as well. So check, check, check. One slightly annoying thing with the Pico is the pins aren't labeled on the top, so it might be worth printing out that diagram. So let's install this piece of software, Thonny. So let's go to their website. I'm running on a Mac, so I'll download the Mac version. And now we'll just install this piece of software. Okay, that was fairly painless. So what's next? Let's go back here. Da, da, da. So launch Thonny from your application launcher. So let's do that. And now we have Thonny up and running. So let's see what's next. So we're just going to run some Python code. So let's try printing hello world. No, that seems to work. Okay, so what's next? MicroPython firmware. So push the boot cell button while you're connecting it. So let's do that quickly. So disconnect. I do think this cable is eventually going to break. So I've seen a few people on the internet putting reset buttons on their Pico. So I think that would be a good idea. So let's see. So now, I think I've already got MicroPython installed, but we'll run through the installation steps again. So we'll click on this, and it's popped up a window, so we'll just run the install process. Okay, that's done. So what's next? Da-da-da. So, yep, use the shell. Okay, let's see what happens. So, look at the shell prompt, and we should see Raspberry Pi. So let's, I can see I've got some red text. So let's just try plugging in again and see if that works. And let's try stop and restart. It seems if you don't see the prompt, stop and restart is the button to push. So now we should be able to do some more printing and we'll print hello. Yeah, that seems to work as well. So let's see if we can actually do something here. So it looks like we're going to be lighting up an LED. So we copy and paste the code. It seems like I have to push return twice when copying and pasting from the website. That's probably just my machine, but if nothing happens, then you should do that. So the LED works. And let's try turning it off. So we're basically just turning off and on the built-in LED. Okay, so what's next then? The classic blink sketch. So, okay, so now we're going to use the main editor. So let's copy this code into here. So pin 25 is the built-in LED, and we're just going to turn it on and off. So click the run button, and we'll save it on the... Let's see what they say. Okay, so they want us to save it on the device. So let's save it to the Raspberry Pi Pico, and we'll call it blink.py. Okay, so the LED is on because we hit run. What happens if we run again? Okay, so we're just switching the LED off and on using this LED toggle. So what's next? So we're going to use a timer now. So we need to add timer to the import, and then we create a timer, and now we have this callback function. I think we'll just copy this and paste it in. And then we're running a timer, which we'll call this blink function. I guess that's 2.5 times a second. So let's run that. Okay, so now our LED is blinking. So that was fairly painless. So let's stop that. So what's next? So what are we going to do? Okay, so a resistor and an LED and a couple of jumpers. Let me dig those out. Okay, so let's see. So they want us to put an LED from ground and a resistor from pin 25 to the LED. And then we just need a connector from the Pico's ground to the ground of the LED. So what's next? Okay, so all we're doing is changing the pin number to pin 15, which is the output we've connected the LED to. And then we're just toggling it. So let's run that. And nothing's happening. So I think I've got my LED the wrong way around. Okay, another blinking LED. Pretty good. So what are we doing now? A button. Okay, let me go and find a button. And we'll stick this in. I'm running out of space. I'm not sure which way around this button actually works. I think it's this way around. So we'll stick that in. And they want us to connect that to the positive supply. So 3.3 volts. So we need another couple of jumpers. So let's wire up the 3.3 from the Pico. Make sure we don't short circuit. Okay. And now we'll connect the button up to that positive rail. Okay, and then they want us to connect this to the pin that's just above where we connected the resistor. So let's stick that in there. So what's next? Oh, pin 14. Okay. So now adding a button connected to pin 14 and setting it to input and making it a pull down. I'll just copy all this code. So yeah, so we've still got the LED on pin 15. We have a button on pin 14. It's an input and we're using a pull down resistor. I'll just fix this white space. And when the button's pushed, we toggle the LED. Let's see what happens. Absolutely nothing interesting. There we go. Let's try that again. Is it working? Okay, there we go. So now when we push the button, the LED toggles. I think that cable's a bit dodgy. Okay, what's next? Okay, we can hold the button down and it will flash. That makes sense. So, okay. Controlling brightness with PWM. So pulse width modulation. So what are we doing now? So let's copy this code. So we're now importing PWM and we're connecting PWM to pin 15. We're setting the frequency to 1 kHz. It's interesting, this number 65025. You'd normally expect it to be 63535, but let's run this and see what happens. Okay, so our LED is glowing on and off. So let's check this number. It seems strange. I'm going to change it to the full range of int 16 and just see what happens. Well, it still works. So what's next? Okay, so we're going to start doing some analog to digital converter. Now, this will be interesting. So we need a potentiometer now. So let's go and find a potentiometer and wire that up. I think I definitely need a slightly bigger breadboard for this. So we want to connect the right-hand side of the potentiometer to positive. And get that wire in. And then the left-hand side of the potentiometer to negative. Okay, and then the center tap is going to pin 10 pins down, so it's that one. So let's copy this code. So what are we doing now? So we're going to be reading from pin 26 using the ADC. So as we turn the potentiometer, we should see the value changing from its maximum to its minimum. So maximum 65535 down to, well, that's as far left as I can go. So there's a slight offset on the ADC. So what's next? So it looks like now we're going to control the PWM by reading from the ADC. So let's try this out. So as I turn my potentiometer up, the LED gets brighter. As I turn it down, the LED gets dimmer. So we have a basic dimming circuit. Okay, so what's next? Power your Raspberry Pi Pico. Okay, so they want us to save this file. And they want us to save it to main.py. Okay, device is busy. Let's try hitting the stop button. Let's try that again. Okay, save to main. Okay, and now once connected, it should run automatically. So let's disconnect from our computer and we'll connect up to a USB power pack and see if it works. So I've disconnected from the computer. Now I'm just gonna plug into a USB power pack. Okay, seems to be working. So our sketch in main.py now runs every time the Pi boots. So I think that might, what's next? Yeah, that's it. So that was the intro to the Raspberry Pi Pico. I must admit, I actually quite enjoyed that. That was quite fun. So it's quite nice, this embedded Python. Pretty cool. So I might try MicroPython on my ESP32 sometime. That was quite enjoyable. Hope you enjoyed this as well, and I'll see you in the next video.